Now that summer is officially here, the garden has really started to kick off, so I thought it was about time for us to go through and do a tour. So it's been about a month since my last garden tour video, and it is amazing to me all that can happen out in the garden in just a month. If you've been following me on Snapchat or Instagram or on my daily vlogging channel, then you've seen some little updates here and there, but I think even you are gonna be really, really surprised just to see how much has happened in such a short amount of time. Now, if you missed the last garden tour video, I'll link that for you because I kind of go through the layout and where everything is located in the garden. I'm not gonna do all of that again today, but if you kind of want that background and to know more about what we have going on out here, then you can go check out that video. So to start off, I'll give you a little overview of everything. So as you can see, you know, a month ago, there was not all of this greenery. There were some plants in the ground, but now, as you look across, it's just all green. This side of the garden, not as much. We've got some things that are taking a little more time over here that are a little smaller, but still, I mean, when you just look out at that, it's so nice to look out from the window in the house and see all of this stuff growing out here. So to start off, let's work on this side of the garden. I'll show you what's going on over here. So this is kind of like our tomato and climbing bean section with some other stuff thrown in. So we have tomatoes and beans alternating here. And I mean, the tomatoes are looking great. The beans are climbing. These right here are rattlesnake beans. So we're just getting flowers on them now. No beans yet because they got planted a little later. But these are green, but then they kind of have flashes of purple across them. So I thought that was really, really fun. So I'm excited to see what those look like. And then we've also got some peppers growing down here. These are hot peppers. And we also have some that kind of had a rough start. These guys are mustard habaneros. This one and that one over there, and they kind of got whittled down to their stems by some sort of critter. I don't know what it was, but we put this cage around them to protect them. I don't know if it was a bug or what, but their leaves are coming back, so I don't know if they'll make it. I'm hoping we'll still get some habaneros out of them. I mean, obviously they've really been set back a lot, but I'm still hoping that it will work out and we'll get something before the season is over. Also have some calendula down here that hasn't bloomed yet, but as you can see, it looks like it's got a little bud on there and it's ready to. And here's some more that are kind of coming along the way. There's another little bud there, so that's fun. And of course, more tomatoes, more beans, because they're yummy. And I've got 36 tomato plants out here in total. For some people, that probably sounds like a lot. For others, maybe it doesn't sound like very much at all. But I like to grow a lot of heirloom varieties. So in there, we have so many different types, different cherry sizes, as well as medium and large tomatoes. So we're really gonna have a lot of different stuff coming out once the plants really start producing. And this bed is basically the same thing, except we also have some determinate type tomatoes down here, just kind of sprawling. And as you can see, we also have some gaps here where I could still put more stuff if I want to. And then these beans right here are purple potted pole beans. So you can see their stems are purple right here, like where it's twisting up the tomato cage, which these have worked out to be great trellises, by the way. We love them for our tomatoes, but they're great for the beans too. And we've got them set up for some other plants as well. And I have a tutorial on that, so I'll link that for you too if you want to know how to make these. They are so sturdy and I just can't say enough about them. But these guys also, no beans yet. We're starting to get some little buds of flowers and stuff, but they haven't even bloomed. So again, a little bit behind maybe where some other people's beans are, but they're still gonna get there. And so they're all just kind of growing across here. They're coming into this tomato cage. I'm trying to keep them off the tomatoes because I don't want them to like start climbing up the tomatoes too much, but they're pretty much all staying in their own little area and I haven't had any real problems with it so far. Coming back to the next bed, it's still a similar setup with tomatoes and beans, just different kinds. This guy wants to come all out of his cage, so I've kind of been trying to bend him back. And also, if we look down here, these are Mexico midget tomatoes, and these are the first ones we have that are actually starting to turn. So they're getting a little color to them. All of our other tomatoes right now are green, so these are usually the first guys that we get to eat in the summer. And then if we come around here, we also have some flowers. This is globe amaranth, and these are pink. The seed packet had different colors, but I guess these are the ones that wanted to survive. So these will be really pretty, and all of these little sections will kind of bud up with the flower, and they're just a really nice addition to have in the garden. We've also got some peppers in this bed. This one, you know, is doing okay, starting to get some flowers, so that's nice. We've got more coming down here. Some of our peppers are doing really well and some of them aren't doing very well at all. And I think it's because I just had so many packed in the seed tray and it was way more than we had even planned for. So some of them I kind of knew might not survive, but I stuck them out here anyways, just in case. Some of them have done great, some of them haven't, but it's still more than what we expected. So it's not that big of a deal. And then coming back here, more peppers, more tomatoes, more beans, all this stuff is happening. So you've got this guy here. I don't even know what this is. I don't have stuff marked out here, but I do have it marked inside on my little plan on the computer. But that guy is really, really exciting. Look at him, he's so cute. These guys I'm pretty sure are white cherry tomatoes. So those are fun, and I've never actually grown those before. I got them from someone on Instagram, actually. We did a little trade. I'll link her account in the description if you want to see her account. The girl I got them from, she has chickens and everything, and she's very gardening focused on what she posts, so it's all really pretty. So I'll put that link for you in the description if you're looking for some gardening type Instagram accounts to follow. But she just reached out to me. She saw some of the tomatoes I was growing and wanted to do a little swap, so I got the white cherries from her, and I'm excited to see what they're like, because I really like the black cherries, and people who like those seem to also like the white cherries, so I'm hoping that they might be a new favorite. Then back here in this bed, we're kind of getting into the cucumber section, and there's some really exciting stuff going on back here too. And it is really hot and I'm getting sweaty, but I'm trying to keep my hair out of my face. So first things, we have Mexican sour gherkins. I've never grown these. They are really interesting. It's kind of like a fun experiment, but let's see if I can find, there's one. These guys are supposed to get, oh, that leaf's in the way. They're supposed to get about an inch long, and they're supposed to taste sour like they're pickled, and they look like little bitty baby doll watermelons. They're crazy. They're supposed to fall off once they're ripe, so I'm trying to keep an eye on them. Never done it before, but it just seemed like such a cool thing, so I had to try it. And then we've got other cucumbers. Some of these plants are still pretty small back here, but then we've got like this guy is really doing well. And he's got a little cucumber coming off here, which is really fun. So we've got a few that are starting to grow, and then we've got these tomato cages here for the cucumbers to crawl up. Up here, we have a row of beans too in the mix, because I like to try to mix everything together. I'm gonna put my phone down because it's hard to carry it and talk to you at the same time. We try to mix everything up because, one, it's just nice for the beds to not just have one type of plant in there for the soil, but also for the way it looks, and also for bugs, both beneficial bugs and the bugs that kind of want to eat on things and not play very nice. So I try to mix things up just to keep everything really healthy. And it's also fun to have stuff mixed all around. It's a lot more aesthetically pleasing, at least I think so. So these are a bush bean, and we actually have some here that I need to pick. So these are really fun, and I'm excited to take these. These are provider, I'm pretty sure, but as you can see, we have some here that we need to pick. And this is my first year, ugh, it's so hot out here, this is my first year growing any type of beans, bush beans or climbing beans. I did some dry beans last year, but they didn't do that well, so I'm not counting those. But as far as string beans, these are my first ones, and so far things are looking pretty good, so I'm pretty pumped about that. Now, if we move over to the bed next door, this has more cucumbers. As you can see, there's some guys down in here that are growing. So we're gonna be getting our first cucumbers very, very soon. And then we also have some borage, however you wanna say it. These little pretty blue flowers, they're so gorgeous. And they're supposed to bring in some beneficial insects as well, some pollinators and stuff. So those are really pretty. And we kind of have those all across the front here. It looks like this little guy has fallen over. He's getting too heavy for himself. I don't know, I'll have to look into that. But yeah, so these guys are doing great too. And I had discovered a possible slug problem out here with them. And I think that was in my last tour, actually. That might be right. There were some slugs. They were eating on the cucumbers. But what I did is I put some crushed eggshells around the plants and some coffee grounds, and the plants did fine. I guess that's what deterred the slugs. I mean, you can never know for sure, but they survived, they grew, and they made it through it, which is what matters to me. Then I guess we'll move forward and work on this bed. We've got more peppers here, sweet peppers in here. I planted some nasturtiums. Some of them came up, but not all of them. They're supposed to be all around here, so that didn't really work out. but you know, we try things, we see what happens. Then as we move forward, we have more tomatoes because I love tomatoes. So we've got all these guys here, and then we've got this little basil forest is what I'm calling it. So we've got Italian basil here, which, you know, is just classic, delicious. But then we also have some spicy globe basil and some Thai basil. So that's really fun. And I actually used a Thai basil last night when I made some drunken noodles, and that was really, really good. I definitely recommend, if you're starting off with growing stuff, even if you're just, if you don't have space outside, definitely do herbs, because you can do them indoors. They're great because they add so much flavor to your food, and they're so expensive to buy in the store, but they're relatively cheap to grow. It's amazing, the savings, especially if you use a lot of herbs in your cooking. So herbs are the way to go on that one. This bed is really nice, more tomatoes. Like I said, lots of green tomatoes growing, just not a lot ripening yet. And then these here are a melon. This is the Petit Gris de Rennes. It's a French melon, and there's three plants in here, but they have just like exploded. You can see they're coming out the front here. They're going that way. They've kind of gone through the back and popped out over on this side. So they're just coming through in all directions, which is really, really exciting. And we've even started to get our first little melons here. So we have this guy here, and then I spotted a couple more back in here. Yeah, so we've got two little guys there, and I'm sure there's more in here that I haven't even found yet, but it's really exciting. And these are fun because they're a very small melon, so it's good because you don't have to worry about them taking forever to ripen. And like, I'd rather have a lot of little small fruits that we kind of eat here and there than like get a few big fruits that we have to eat all at once and really have to take care of long term as they're growing. That's my personal preference. So we've got those. Now this bed right here is the same setup, but as you can see, not doing as well. So more tomatoes, but these guys are tracking behind like everyone else in the garden that's a tomato is like up here. And it's just, I mean, the difference between this bed and this bed, I think, is crazy. I don't know what's happening. I don't know if it's just even that small of a distance over, the soil is very different, or the sunlight. I don't know. It's really weird, but it's just, you know, part of the whole gardening thing. So more tomatoes here. They're doing something. They're just lagging behind everyone else. And same with these melons. These are the Boule d'Or melons. They're also a smaller melon type. And they are growing, okay? They're not, like, dying. And they've definitely come out even in the past couple weeks, but obviously not taken off like the guys in the other bed, which is fine. I know we're gonna get good food from it either way. It's just kind of interesting to me to see like those two beds right next to each other and how much difference there is and what's actually happening. Tomatillos are looking good. We have three green tomatillos over in this bed, and they've got little flowers and everything going on there, so you know they'll be coming along soon. And then if we go over to the next bed behind it, there were three purple tomatillos here, but this one just ate it. I don't know what happened to them. This one almost died, but we were able to save it and bring it back, so that's fine. So purple tomatillos here, and then this one is just like going crazy. And the thing with tomatillos is you need at least two so they can pollinate each other, because they're not self-pollinating. So that was my worry, like if enough didn't survive, then we might not have anything, but we've got plenty, so that will be fine. The herb beds, not a lot going on because I didn't really put anything out. None of the chives that I tried to plant came up, so whatever. I think I just got them out here way too late. But we did get some mint from my in-laws because it grows like a weed, and they had plenty, so they gave us some. And then the catnip over here is doing really well. It's nice and pretty. It's kind of fuzzy, which I didn't realize because I've never had fresh catnip before, but it feels really soft. It's kind of cool. And then this one over here isn't doing as well, but it's still doing okay. So I don't know what the plan is for this. It was kind of just like, my hair is like sticking to my face, my neck. It's too hot. But the catnip, I don't have a plan for it. I mean, you can make tea out of it, I know, and obviously our cats might like it. It's not really something I'm growing for the economics of it, more just for the fun of trying it out. If you have any uses for catnip other than giving it to your cats or using it for tea, let me know, because I don't really have a plan for it. I'm just kind of growing it and seeing what happens. This bed back here, this needs a little weeding done. But we've got some rosemary, still very small. If I get out the light, you can actually see, still very small, but there are a couple plants like this out here. And then the lemon balm, if we come over here, this guy is doing great. We've got several of these plants, and so this is going to be fun too, just to have something else to put in, you know, like tea or for water or something. There's some grass growing up I need to pull up, but you know, everything overall with this mulching thing with the wood chips and the cardboard and the leaves and everything is working really well. I mean, I never come out here and weed. We come out here every few weeks and we'll just go through and pick through stuff, or like if I'm walking through and I see something, I'll grab it. But I mean, it's amazing how little I have to do and it all just works, which is really nice. And I definitely would say that if I do some weed, I'm not gonna come out in the middle of the day like I am right now, because it's too hot for that. Back here, more tomatoes. These were actually extras we just stuck in here and they're doing great. This is a little bit of a mess. Some arugula in here, but some grass is coming up in between it. It's hard to pull it out though. So once the arugula is done, as you can see, it's starting to flower. So it's about done. Then I can kind of clean this area up. And then lettuce, this is the oak leaf. It's not doing so well right now because it's so freaking hot out here, but this did great. I mean, it just came up perfect. This right here did okay. Not as many came up, but we've been eating on that. We have gotten a lot of lettuce out of this garden, so that's really exciting. And that's another thing, that if you're new and you wanna try stuff out in the springtime, growing some lettuce, pretty easy. And I mean, it can get pricey in the store. So, and that, especially if you don't eat it all and it goes bad and all that stuff. So growing lettuce is pretty good. Back here, ground cherries. These are fun. They're supposed to be like a cross between a tomato and a pineapple in flavor. You can see they're kind of like a tomatillo. They've got the similar type of flowers going on. And if I can find some, yeah, there's some back here. They have this same kind of little lantern thing that the tomatillos do as well, but it's sweet. It's got like a sweetness. Yeah, there's some more under there. So these are fun. I don't know how much we'll get out of them or how well they'll do, but you know, they're growing and it's just another thing that's gonna be a fun experiment. We got more beans back here doing great. Also zinnias, which just fun. Flowers are great. I've never grown these before. And this is our first one. I'm just seeing this for the first time with you. Look at that flower, isn't that pretty? So fun. And so they should just pop off all these little sides. I'm really excited about these. The idea of having fresh flowers that we can just cut and bring in, it's really exciting to me. And this is a mix of different colors, which is also really cool. So got this one that's kind of like this red orange kind of color going on. This one looks like it might be darker than the one that's blooming. Oh, look at this guy. That's one of the orangey ones. Then there's some yellow ones over here. That guy is a white one. Another like magenta colored one. So that's really cool, because I don't know, I never am someone who wants to go out and buy flowers, but having these in my garden, like what more could you ask for? And then if we move across to this section, we've got some flowers here. They're growing. We've got this, which is, why can't I think of the name? I'm forgetting the name right now, but it's a weed, but it's edible, so I'm just letting that happen. And then we've got sweet peppers back here. We have a little squash plant back here. He's looking a little sad, but I think he's gonna make it. We planted our squash kind of late because we're going away on a trip and we have a squash bug problem. And so I didn't want to put him out here and let him get attacked, because I wasn't gonna ask like my mom and my mother-in-law when they were coming over to check on the cats. I wasn't gonna ask them to like come out here and pick off squash bugs. So I put him out late. Not all of them survived the process, but we've got a couple. So that's all I really need. We've got more peppers. Super fun. And then these guys have been a fun experiment. This is our snap pea section, and I did these again on those same tomato cages. They're awesome. They're obviously meeting the end of their rope now, but I mean, we've getting things like this off and they're really good. Great for snacks. I thought I might put them in stir fries and stuff, but we've basically just been eating them raw. We took them when we went to VidCon as a snack, so it was nice to have some veggies around. And like I said, they're still eking out a little bit more, but their time is coming to an end pretty shortly. So now that I'm all gross and sweaty, that's a look at what we've got going on in the garden right now. Let me know in the comments if you are growing stuff, what you're growing, how it's doing, because I'd love to hear about that. And if you are new to my channel and you want more healthy eating tips and nutrition info and healthy recipes, make sure that you subscribe, because eating healthy and living a healthy lifestyle really doesn't have to be complicated, and I want to show you how to do it. Thanks for watching. I hope you're having a great day, and I'll talk to you next time.